Good day from Chem Help ASAP. This video provides practice problems for predicting the regiochemical outcome of electrophilic aromatic substitution reactions. All of these problems have been pulled from the chemical literature. Citations are on the slides. Check the video description to find links to printable copies of these problems and their solutions. Furthermore, links during the video will connect you to other videos that provide more detail on these types of reactions. Electrophilic aromatic substitutions, EAS reactions, often involve questions of regiochemistry. If you do a substitution on a ring that already has a substituent, an R group, then is the new group introduced ortho, meta, or para relative to the original group? This is a regiochemistry question. In general, the regiochemistry depends on the nature of the R group. If the R group is an ortho-para director, then the new group will prefer to land in the ortho or para position. Ortho-para directors are groups that can donate electron density and include alkyl groups, oxy groups like methoxy, halogens, and some amino groups. In contrast, if the R group is a meta director, then the new group will prefer to bind to the meta position. Meta directors are generally electron withdrawing groups and include nitro, carbonyls, and nitriles. Those are the main ideas. Let's now apply these ideas to a series of reactions pulled from the literature. Here is our first reaction. This is a Friedel-Crafts acylation with acetyl chloride. The R group in the starting material is a methyl group. That is an ortho-para director. So the acetyl group go in an ortho or para position. Normally, because the para position is less sterically hindered than the ortho position, the para position is favored. So electronically, both the ortho and para positions are favored, while sterically, the para position is favored over the ortho position. What product is reported in the literature? It is almost exclusively the para product. The researchers reported an 82% yield of the para product and 3% of the ortho product. Note that at just 3%, it would be very easy to miss the formation of the ortho product. In an NMR spectrum, you might not notice peaks from a 3% impurity. Similarly, if the product were a solid, you might recrystallize the crude product, filter away the minor regioisomer, and never even realize that the reaction gave a mixture of products. Regardless, in this reaction, we can see that both possible regioisomers, ortho and para, were observed. Presumably, the para product is favored because of steric repulsions at the ortho positions. Problem 2. This is a halogenation, a bromination. The starting material is anisole with a methoxy group on the ring. Methoxy is a strong electron donating group, so we would expect the ortho or para product. Most likely the para product because of steric hindrance at the ortho positions. I will note that this reagent is a bit unusual. Normally we see Br2 and FeBr3 in brominations, but anisole is so reactive with that electron donating group that a less reactive reagent like NBS and bromosacinamide can still perform the reaction. The observed product is just the para product in a high yield of 95%. Could some of the ortho product have formed? Perhaps, but presumably no more than 5% could have formed as the ortho product. The para product is favored because of sterics. Problem 3. Here is a case in which the ring is attached to a carbonyl. That is an electron withdrawing group, and the regiochemistry will favor the meta product. I would point out these bromination reagents. Normally, I recommend that students use FeBr3 as the Lewis acid with Br2, but that's not an absolute requirement for the reaction to work. Here is the observed bromination product, just the meadow regioisomer with a nice high yield of 85%. Next question. We have two R groups on this ring, so the questions are getting more complicated. The nitro group is a metadirector and favors reaction at these two carbons, meta relative to the nitro group. The methyl group is an ortho paradirector and favors the same two carbons, ortho relative to the methyl. The methyl also favors reaction where the nitro is, but that position is already occupied. So both R groups favor the same reaction site. What is the product? Just as we expected, chlorination occurs at the activated carbon. A key idea for this question is to recognize that the site of reaction is determined relative to each R group. If you have two R groups, you need to redefine the ortho, meta, and para positions relative to each R group you are considering. Before leaving this question, I'll comment on the Lewis acid for the reaction, the zeolite. Zeolites are porous, often powdered glass-like materials. The surface and pores of the material can act as a Lewis acid, a good enough Lewis acid to catalyze a chlorination reaction on an aromatic ring in this case. Here is the next problem, and this one is a bit interesting. The starting material is toluene. The methyl group on the ring is an ortho para director. In general, I teach students to assume that the ortho position is sterically hindered by the R group, so para substitution strongly predominates. What does the literature say that this reaction gives? Bam! The major product is the ortho product. It's 35% ortho to 24% para. How can you get more ortho than para? That seems impossible. Don't forget that there are two ortho carbons relative to para. Statistically speaking, if sterics weren't part of the picture, you might expect a 2-to-1 ratio of ortho to para. The observed ratio is less than 2-to-1, but it's certainly not all para either. Despite this experimental result, which clearly shows that ortho products can form and are experimentally observed, I would still encourage students to focus on the para product because normally para is the major regioisomer and often the major regioisomer by a large margin. In this particular case, however, ortho dominates. That's likely because the methyl group is actually quite small. Sometimes seeing exceptions to a rule can help one learn more about the limitations of the rule and better understand chemical reactions. Okay, problem 6. Now we have two electron donating groups, one methyl and a methoxy. The methyl group will activate the ortho positions here and here. The methoxy group will activate its ortho positions here and here. Uh-oh, these two groups are activating different positions. Which one wins? Here is the major product. How do we explain this result? Well, the methoxy group is the stronger director because it can stabilize the intermediate with resonance. Let's react this ring with a simple electrophile, Al+. If we get attack by the ring, ortho to the methoxy, then we get this cation intermediate. Note that the oxygen lone pair can donate to make another resonance form. While you might not like the O plus in the resonance form, this new resonance form does have a full octet, which is the number one rule of Lewis structures. This is better than any intermediate we can draw if we go ortho to the methyl. The stability of this intermediate from attack ortho to the methoxy group explains the observation of the product shown in high yield. Number 7. Again, we have two groups on the ring. Both are alkyl groups, so both are ortho-para directors. In essence, the question is, will we get substitution ortho to the methyl or ortho to the isopropyl? Here is the product. The electrophile goes ortho to the methyl group. In this example, we can explain the outcome through sterics. The isopropyl group is bigger. It more strongly blocks its ortho positions. The electrophile therefore goes ortho to the methyl. Next question. Once again, two groups on the ring. Now it's a methyl and chloro. This is actually a lot like question 6, which had the methyl and methoxy. The methyl will favor ortho. The chloro will favor ortho. All four unsubstituted carbons will be activated. So what was observed as the product? Aha, the chloro wins out. I find this kind of interesting. Methyl is the stronger activator. In fact, chloro is a ring deactivator. Chloro, however, has a lone pair to stabilize the cation intermediate, just like we saw in problem 6. I will note that the yield is only 46%. A completely fair question is, what about the other 54%? It's possible that a lot of the other regioisomer, the acetyl ortho to the methyl, was formed in the reaction. In this case, I think we need to give the author some credit. If the other regioisomer was observed, then the article would likely record that observation in the results. So again, we see in this example that having an additional resonance form, especially one in which you have a full octet, can drive the regiochemical outcome of the reaction. Last question. This one builds on questions 6 and 8. Let's number the unsubstituted carbons. 1, 2, 3. The methyl group favors carbon 2, which is para to the methyl. Both chloro groups activate 1 and 3. Carbon 1 is ortho to one chlorine and para to the other. The same is true for carbon 3. So 1 and 3 are more activated, but 1 and 3 are more sterically hindered. Carbon 2 is unhindered, but less activated. This is a very interesting case. What is the major product? Here we go. It's carbon 3, or 1. I wish I had a yield for this, but I don't. Regardless, from problem 8, we know that a single chloro is a stronger director than a single methyl. In this problem, we have two chlorines as directing groups. It's not too surprising that the directing of two chlorines is strong enough to override any steric effects and determine the regiochemical outcome of the reaction. I'm not sure I would have predicted this outcome, but once I see the result, I can make sense of it. One more final comment. Look at the reagents. Iron is listed under the arrow. Normally we'd show FeBr3. Iron is not the same as FeBr3. Well, in the reaction, iron, metallic iron, likely iron filings, will react quickly with Br2 to form FeBr3. So, while the researchers used iron in the reaction, FeBr3 was formed in the reaction to serve as a Lewis acid for activating the Br2. I hope you enjoyed these problems and that they help you better understand regiochemistry and EAS reactions. Please subscribe to the channel, like this video, or leave a comment. Thank you for watching. Remember that links to these problem sets are in the video description. Take care.